children, take out your geography book, chapter 10, India, Human Resources. Today's topic, migration. What does migration mean? Migration refers to the movement of people. It can be within the country or may lead to the movement to other countries. Now, migration, what does it mean? It means movement of the people from either within the country or it may from country to country. It can be of major, it can lead to major changes in population. Even it can lead to major changes in population, it is due to better opportunity. Even it happens due to better opportunities in other region, that people would like to migrate. Now, people who come to settle from other regions or countries are called immigrant population. Now, people who come from other regions or the countries, what are they called? They call immigrant population. The outgoing population from their country are called immigrant population, and the outgoing population of their own country, what are they called? They are called the immigrant population. Globalization has led to changes in population composition due to immigration. Now, globalization, what it has led to? It has led to changes in the population composition. What? Due to the immigration. Now, rural-urban population. The rural-urban population is high in comparison to urban population, as India is an agricultural country. Now, rural-urban population, what is it? It is very high when it is compared to urban population, and as India is an agriculture. Because India is what? It is an agriculture. People are more or less engaged in agriculture or agro-based industry. Now, people, what are they engaged in? People are more or less they are engaged in agriculture or they are engaged in agro-based industry. In urban areas, people are engaged in non-agriculture. And in urban areas, what happened? People, they are engaged in non-agricultural activities. Gradually, with growing opportunities of jobs, education, health and better lifestyle, people tend to move to urban areas. Now, gradually what happened? With the growing opportunities of jobs, what happened? Education and even the better lifestyle, people, what happened? They try to move to urban areas. Most of these rural-urban migration are happening in metropolitan cities such as Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata and Bengaluru. Now, most of it, this rural-urban migration. Why they are happening? They are happening in the metropolitan cities, that is Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata and Bengaluru. What it leads to? It leads to faster growth. Faster growth, that is faster growth rate of population in these cities. On the other hand, rural population has largely increased. On the other hand, what happens? Rural population, they are rarely increasing. Now, sex ratio. The number of females per 1,000 males is termed as sex ratio. Now, what is called the sex ratio? That is the number of females. That means among per 1,000 males, it is only called the sex ratio. A well-balanced sex ratio is indicative of a progressive country. If there is a well-balanced sex ratio, then what happened? It is good for a progressive country. According to 2011 census, the average sex ratio of India shows 940 females to 100,000 males in India. Now, according to 2011 census, what happened? The average sex ratio of India, what it shows? It shows to 940 females, that is from among 1,000 males in India. What happened? It was 940 females. People are a nation's wealth. People are what? They are nation's wealth. That means country's wealth. Hence, healthy and skilled population is an economic strength of a nation. And so, healthy and skilled population, what is? That is an economic strength of a country. Now, take out your diary, right? Right? Chapter 10, India, Human Resources, topic, page 115, 116, and 117, explain, homework, revise it. And with this, I am ending my today's class.